Okay, folks, probably a little bit what you might call off-piste with this Model Railway exhibition. I was one of the founder members of the Christchurch Model Railway Club many, many years ago, and I moved away other things and whatnot. I just thought I'd go out and film this and hope it's of interest to you guys.
Yeah. we've got the pool models and the tents. Like Martin, if we go, they've got a table for two. So me and you can go.
So we swap.
Swap?
Yeah.
What did you order?
Just a sandwich.
Right.
Being nice to Emmy because she's got it's all good fun,
yeah.
Right, I need to go
Have it.
How are you doing, all right?
Yeah, not bad.
Nice bit of video there.
Yeah, get a few foot, a bit of footage in. We'll edit it down eventually to 20 minutes maybe for YouTube.
How handy is it to have one of those?
Very. I do a few walking videos for my YouTube channel. And if you carry the camera on any way when you're walking, you get this little picture.
Oh, yeah.
Unless you can sort of shuffle and slide. You walk.
Yeah.
And I've tried carrying it on a tripod to give it weight.
Yeah.
And that. And, you know, you get this as you walk along.
Yeah.
The picture's going... Which is not so bad if you're looking on a phone, but you're looking on a widescreen TV and you're trying to watch it doing this. Whereas it doesn't totally cancel it, but it takes most of it.
Yeah.
But the big thing is with that...
That's quite smooth, isn't it?
Yeah?
Yeah.
And if you want a pan, rather than get the jerky pan...
Yeah.
Push the right buttons.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's a neat
bit of kit. And then do that.
Yeah.
And you can tilt it down.
Wow. But
then it comes back level. There's all sorts of stuff
that's
it
so
does.
Cool.
But the big thing I got it from was I'm doing a walking sort of video. It was this one. You go. No matter how hard, as you get older, your walking tends to be, I got a bit of a limp as well, it was just awful, you know. Well, this at least picture ended sort of just,
yeah.
You know, a little bit. And I did one on the Swanage Railway.
Mm.
Well, if you just put the camera down on the table on the train, and it's going...
Yeah.
You get the feel as if you're sat on the train, but it's not what viewers want to see, you know.
No.
And by that, it just smooths it out. But it's things like this when you're trying to get in here.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's really neat.
Clip.
What's wrong with that?
Mm.
Like this, which is our seed bus system. This system, we're using CAN bus as our data lines.
Right.
So basically, if you've got a large layout, instead of having multiple cables with XR
positive and negative, one forward supplies. Two data lines at the moment. Actual fact, it's three data lines, but we use the 0 and the 12 volt as the zero of the data line of the data system, and then by hand low. So it's a three wire.
Okay, but instead, as I say, instead of having multi connectors, you have 56 ways. And whatever you want to put around your layout, it's a mix and match system. Whatever you want to put around your layout, you put a board in there. Say you want, you've got a group of points somewhere. Then you put a board to run that group. This board, for example, this board here can run up to 8 servos. You can also say the So what happens is that goes onto the bus and it goes to all the boards. But we teach the boards using the CEO. We teach the boards what messages to wrap on.
Huh?
Scale uncoupling hook.
Thank you. Put the grass passing too close.
Wrong kind of leaves.
The wrong kind, yeah, it's leaves on the line. Bloody great bush growing on it.
Well, you have to think of scaling that up. That's probably a rainforest.
I think you've got a bit over enthusiastic with these. Yeah. I mean, plonking it down in the monk's suit.
Weathering and going to get carried away in there.
I don't know the milk trains.
Yeah, I do like the milk trains.
He's off.
Bye-bye.
You want me? I can do it.
Gives him an excuse to do it. I like that.
I'm going to go to the next one.